History is not just stuff that happens by accident. We are the products of the history that our ancestors chose, if we're white. If we are black, we are products of the history that our ancestors most likely did not choose. Yet here we all are together, the products of that set of choices, and we have to understand that in order to escape from it. The 13th Amendment to the Constitution makes it unconstitutional for someone to be held as a slave. In other words, it grants freedom to all Americans. There are exceptions, including criminals.
There's a clause, a loophole.
If you have that embedded in the structure, in this constitutional language, then it's there to be used as a tool for whichever purposes one wants to use it. You were basically a slave again. The 13th Amendment says that, hey, except for criminals, everybody else is free. Well, now if you're criminalized, that doesn't apply to you.
13th Amendment says no involuntary servitude except for those who have been duly convicted of a crime. So once you've been convicted of a crime, you are in essence a slave of the state.
The stroke of a pen is not self-enforcing. And so while the 13th Amendment is hailed as this great milestone for freedom and abolitionists celebrate, and you know this is the end of a lifelong quest, the reality is much more problematic. Well, once that clause is inserted in there, it becomes a tool. It's there, it's embedded in the structure, and for those who seek to use this criminality clause as a tool, it can become a pretty powerful one because it's privileged. It's in the Constitution, it's the supreme law of the land.
Throughout American history, African Americans have repeatedly been controlled through systems of racial and social control that appear to die, but then are reborn in new form tailored to the needs and constraints of the time. You know, after the collapse of slavery, a new system was born, convict leasing, which was a new form of slavery. And once convict leasing faded away, a new system was born, a Jim Crow system that relegated African Americans to a permanent second-class status. And here we are, decades after the collapse of the old Jim Crow, and a new system has been born again in America, a system of mass incarceration that once again strips millions of poor people, overwhelmingly poor people of color, of the very rights supposedly won in the civil rights movement.
If you dismiss black complaints of mistreatment by police as being completely rooted in our modern context, then you're missing the point completely. There has never been a period in our history where the law and order branch of the state has not operated against the freedoms, the liberties, the options, the choices that have been available for the black community, generally speaking. And to ignore that racial heritage, to ignore that historical context means that you can't have an informed debate about the current state of blacks and police relationship today, because this didn't just appear out of nothing. This is the product of a centuries-long historical process, and to not reckon with that is to shut off solutions.